Mr. Carmenu Vela, Commissioner for Environment, Maritime Affairs and Fisheries, European Commission, other dignitaries on dais, delegates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to address this important gathering of experts and stakeholders from across the world at the World Sustainable Development Summit. It is heartening that distinguished personalities from India and abroad have converged here to deliberate on the issues, challenges, and opportunities in the context of the people, planet, and progress. One of the most important bases of sustenance of life is water, a natural resource which is under tremendous stress because of numerous challenges that it faces. On an average, India receives annual precipitation of about 4,000 kilometer cube. However, because of high spatial and temporal variability of rainfall, water availability exhibits high uncertainty in terms of both space and time. This uncertainty, coupled with the rising demand, over-exploitation, inefficient use and pollution of water resources, has created a situation of water stress. Increasing population, urbanization, consumerism, and changing lifestyle has led to a precariously dangerous situation where demands are outgrowing the availability of natural resources like water. The holy rivers of India, which have been the cradles of civilization, ensuring food security to the local population, are getting exhausted of their natural ability to sustain themselves due to unscrupulous use and pollution from various domestic and industrial sources. The per capita water availability in India has been on continuous decline, which has put our country into water-stressed category and is close to being categorized as water scarce. Many river basins in India are already water stressed due to exploitation of groundwater. Even though the water demand amongst various sectors in India has been continually increasing, the efficiency of water use in these sectors needs to be emphasized. Agriculture, irrigation sector, which consumes about 80% of water use, has a potential of increase in efficiency. Additionally, the vagaries of climate changes are expected to exacerbate the situation, adding to the stress on the finite water resource. Increasing temperatures, erratic rainfall, extreme events like heavy floods and severe droughts are the challenges which require careful consideration in the policies and program of the country to address the issues of sustainability, prosperity, and development. The current and prospective pathways of growth and development in the nations across the world, including India, needs to encompass the equitable, efficient, and sustainable utilization of water resources through integrated approach, participatory planning, and effective implementation. This necessitates a participatory approach with regular stakeholder engagement, collaborations, and sharing of knowledge and best practices across the world. As you would be aware, last year in September, countries across the world adopted the United Nations SDGs Sustainable Development Goals, which under the Goal 6 requires nations to ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all, including access to safe drinking water and sanitation, reducing water pollution, increasing wastewater recycling and reuse, increasing water use efficiency, integrated water resource management, strengthening participation of local communities, and expanding international cooperation, etc. I'm happy to mention that the current government has launched several programs in order to effectively address the challenges in water sector. Consultations have been made with all the stakeholders through Jal Manthan for effective implementation of various programs. With the now well-known Namami Gange program, we have initiated several actions to rejuvenate the holy river of Ganga and promote conservation of water bodies, efficient water use through a Nirmal and Aviral Dhara approach. Under the National Water Mission, the identified goals emphasized on enhancing the water use efficiency by 20%, promoting water conservation, water audits, IWRM, etc. Similarly, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is focused on issues of sanitation and waste management, while the PMKSY, Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchani Yojana, focuses on efficient irrigation with a view of more crop per drop and har khet ko pani, water to every field. Among us, a year back in October, India submitted its INDCS, intended nationally determined contributions, committing to interventions in various sectors, including the water and sanitation sector, involving mitigation and adoption interventions such as wastewater recycling, reuse, zero liquid discharge, ZLD, real-time monitoring, reduction in wastage, enhancing water use efficiency, water conservation, and watershed development, etc. Ensuring water for all is a homogeneous task, and partnerships and collaborations between network of stakeholders, including practitioners and users, local communities, researchers, corporates, and the government have a key role to play. Shouldering this responsibility together is important, not only for ensuring efficient and sustainable water management, but also economic development, social equity, environmental restoration, sustainable development, and human prosperity, something that relates very well to the theme of people, planet, and progress of this WSDS. I'm glad to see that the Minister of Water Resource, River Development, I'm glad to see that the Ministry of Water Resource, River Development, and Ganga Rejuvenation is entering a collaboration with European Union, EU, and is signing an MOU to jointly work towards improvement in management of water resource and to strengthen technological, scientific, and management capabilities of India and EU in the field of water management on the basis of equality and mutual benefit. I hope this partnership will provide a platform that will help facilitate the exchange of knowledge, experience, and expertise to provide solutions to the challenges in water sector. Finally, I compliment Terry for organizing such an event of global significance. I do hope that the deliberations in this World Sustainable Development Summit, WSDS, will bring out the ideas and solutions that may bridge the gaps and promote sustainable management of natural resources and thus contributing to the sustainable development. I wish the World Sustainable Development Summit a great success. Our distinguished guest, Mr. Carmen Uvela, and the other ladies and gentlemen here, I'm really very happy because I could see in Europe how beautifully and with a restraint water is used there. I hope our country will learn a lot from this MOU. I'm looking forward to this. Thank you very much.